that's an open-ended question. If I lived in a neighborhood, that might be one answer. And if I lived on acreage, it might be another answer. But if we were to have to give that as a answer, how many hives could be in one location?
Well, that was an important distinction you made between what is the location where the bees are going to be kept. If the location is in the forest, that's different than the number of colonies that could be kept in a pasture that's a monocrop that's ready to come into bloom.
Right.
And that's also different than a colony of bees or multiple colonies of bees that are kept in a neighborhood. Mm-hmm. Neighborhood bees really do well. If you're in a neighborhood where they landscape, where the flowers are rotated, where there's fruit trees, where there's pollen and nectar almost all year, as opposed to living in a pine forest where there's nothing,
the
answer is completely different. I think that you and I would both agree that once a colony has become established, ideally we believe that you should start with two, and the reasons for that are part of learning beekeeping. But usually you can know when you've overpopulated an apiary by the response that the bees are having when there's nectar and pollen going heavily, and then all of a sudden it stops, but you know that there's a nectar flow.
Mm-hmm.
You had 10 colonies and then you went up to 20.
Right.
Somewhere in that difference, maybe we overloaded that specific site. We've seen that happen.
We had that happen. We had 10 colonies in a particular location and they did great. And then we went to 12 colonies and all of a sudden, just the addition of a few more colonies, they weren't doing so great. So what that told us was their forage really kind of kept it down at that 10 or below.
And incidentally, that was in a pine forest.
It really was.
We maxed them out.
We did. We maxed it out. So what I think our answer should be is, what will your land bear? It kind of throws the answer, the question back on the person asking the question, but what will your little spot in your world support? What is foraging for your bees? I know that backyard beekeepers, and we see this often, if you live in a postage stamp backyard, which a lot of our beekeepers do, you can have 2, 3, 4 colonies and do just fine. Because like you said earlier, those suburban, urban neighborhoods, they've got wonderful forage. That's the best honey in the world. So they could really support probably more than what your neighbors really want them to support.
And that would be the key.
Yeah.
The limiting factor there would be how many your neighbors will allow you to have, because there are times when we have to work our bees.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a number of bees that's acceptable for flying around.
Yeah.
If you live out in the outback in the rural areas, then that's totally up to you.
Sky's the limit.
Watch your honey stores,
mm-hmm.
watch your nectar, watch your pollen, and ensure that it evenly distributes in the colonies.
Right.
And if it does, then you want to keep growing, then do so. You can stretch the limit.
That's right. It's not your goal to have to feed your bees 12 months out of the year and constantly be their source for food and forage. You want them to be able to get what nature's providing, plus to benefit nature from their presence there.
That's right.